Good evening. Welcome to the California State University San Bernardino College of Arts and Letters and the James R. Watson and Judy Rodriguez Watson College of Education, May 2022 commencement ceremony. I am La Sisi and Grand Marshal today. Out of respect for our graduates and in recognition of the importance of this ceremony, we ask that all of you please silence your cell phones and remain in attendance through the completion of the ceremony. Thank you for your cooperation. To begin the commencement ceremony, will the class of 2022 please come forward? Graduates, on your seats, you will find a copy of this year's commemorative commencement programs. Please remember to take it with you as you leave today's ceremony. Will the class of 2022 please rise for the faculty and remain standing for the platform party? Will the faculty please come forward? Okay, thank you. The bearer of the mace is Dr. Terry Nelson, Professor of French. Will the bearer of the mace and the platform party members please come forward?
President Morales, Provost McMahon, Dean Chuang, Dean Domontracu, faculty, honored guests, and graduates. The 55th commencement of the College of Arts and Letters and College of Education at California State University, San Bernardino, is hereby convened. Please remain standing and join in the singing of our national anthem, sung by Ariana Rees, a CSUSB student.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so
one of our very own students. Please join me. Thank you, Ariana. You may be seated. Welcome to the celebration of the success of our students and faculty. I am Sherry McMahon, Provost and Vice President of Academic Affairs. Before we begin, I would like to take a moment to recognize the mace bearer, Dr. Terry Nelson. Would you please stand? Dr. Nelson joined CSUSB in 1995 as a faculty member in French after finishing her PhD at Northwestern University. During her first years, she introduced numerous students and faculty to the brand new world of email and the internet, and also helped language professors throughout the CSU system to learn more about using technology to enhance language learning in their classrooms. Professor Nelson continued to be a faculty trainer for technology as the Associate Director of the Teaching Resource Center, the Cal Dean's Fellow for Online Teaching, and as a leader in numerous workshops. She has also served as the World Languages and Literatures Department Chair, a member of the Faculty Senate, on a wide variety of campus committees, and as the principal investigator for over $2 million in grants designed to enhance the scope and variety of languages offered at CSUSB. She's the recipient of numerous teaching awards, among them the Reacting Consortium's Brilliancy Prize, the CSU's Faculty Innovation and Leadership Award, and the Outstanding Teacher for the California Language Teachers Association. Thank you, Dr. Nelson. We are honored to have you as our mace bearer today. Today is a joyous occasion for our graduates, their families, and friends. Class of 2022, today you join another distinguished group, the alumni of California State University, San Bernardino. I'd now like to recognize the distinguished members of the platform party and ask them to stand as they are introduced. Please hold your applause until they are all introduced. Representing the community, Dr. Paulette Brown Hines, Honorary Doctor of Humane Letters recipient. Representing the university, Dr. Tomas D. Morales, President. From the College of Arts and Letters, Dr. Reiling Shuang, Dean. Dr. Paris Dufais, Associate Dean. Dr. Terry Nelson, Professor, World Languages and Literatures and Bearer of the Mace. From the James R. Watson and Judy Rodriguez Watson College of Education, Dr. Chanaka Domwachuku, Dean. Dr. Stacy Robertson, Associate Dean. Dr. Becky Sumbera, Assistant Dean. Dr. Lasisi Ajayi, Professor, Teacher Education and Foundations, and Ground Marshal. And representing the university community, Dr. Paz Oliveras, Vice President, Student Affairs. Mr. Robert J. Nava, Vice President, University Advancement, and Executive Director, CSUSB Philanthropic Foundation. Dr. Samuel Sudiker, Vice President, Information Technology Services and CIO. Dr. David Wessey, Interim Vice President, Administration and Finance. Mr. Cesar Caballero, Dean of the John M. Pfau Library. Dr. Rachel Beach, Associate Vice President, Enrollment Management. Dr. Leslie Davidson Boyd, Associate Vice President, Academic Success and Undergraduate Advising. Dr. Avicenia Rodriguez, Interim Assistant Dean of Student Engagement, Palm Desert Campus. Ms. Crystal Weimer Lucero, Director, Alumni Engagement. Professor Beth Steffel, Faculty Senate Chair. Ms. Jessica Madrigal, Staff Council Chair. And finally, Ms. Paola Galvez, Executive Vice President, Associated Students Incorporated. Thank you. And now it gives me great pleasure to introduce the Dean of the College of Arts and Letters, Dr. Reiling Chuang.
Hello, graduates. It is always an honor for me to be here and celebrate with you during this momentous occasion. I would first like to begin by recognizing Professor Valerie Morgan from the World Languages and Literature Department for being CSUSB's 2021-2022 Outstanding Lecturer. Congratulations, Professor Morgan. Next, I would like to recognize our College Outstanding Faculty Award winners for this academic year. Dr. Jessica Locke from the English Department is our Outstanding Professor in Teaching. And Dr. Liliana Gonzalez-Gallego from the Communication Studies Department is our Outstanding Professor in Research and Creative Activity. Our outstanding professor in service is Dr. Mihaila Popescu from the Communication Studies Department. And our outstanding lecturer is Dr. Jess Nairn, also from the Communication Studies Department. Please join me in giving a round of applause for our amazing faculty members who go above and beyond in the classroom and in their work. Thank you for all that you do. I would also like to recognize our outstanding students for this academic year. Our outstanding undergraduate student is Farah Strachan from the Liberal Study Program. And our outstanding graduate student is Naheem Aburadi from the Communication Study Department. Congratulations to you both. Please make your way to the front so that you can receive your plaque commemorating your success. I would now like to thank all the graduates here today for your patience and flexibility during the course of your educational journey. It has not been easy with COVID and Omicron variant, but I appreciate your determination to finish your degree in spite of challenging circumstances. Thank you to all your friends and family as well for their support. Finally, I hope you all enjoy our commencement speaker video, which is a wonderful tradition for the College of Arts and Letters. Congratulations to the extraordinary class of 2022. Go Yodis!
Howdy, class of 2022, we've made it. After the last few years, remember to live authentically, mourn globally, and thrive locally. Never stop failing. Continue to build communities and learn from your own and others' mistakes. Your life will continue to lead you into a plethora of possibilities. Whatever path you choose after this point, remember that you absolutely belong, you are capable, and you are seen. Every fiber of your being encourages you to take up space and to thrive unapologetically. Congratulations, class of 2022.
To my partner who supported me throughout my program and never let me give up, to my best friend who never left my side and was there for me every step of the way, to my family who became my very own cheerleaders and loved me unconditionally, to my mentor who never let me fail and guided me throughout my journey, and to all of CSUSB and every faculty member, staff, and student, I have had the pleasure to know, thank you, every single one of you helped this dream become a reality for me. Finally, to all my fellow Coyotes graduating today, keep leaving your paw prints everywhere. Let's show everyone our Coyote pride.
Here at CSUSB, I was able to make a world just for myself. I made friends with similar interests and worked with professors I admire, who guided me along the way. Mom, Dad, thank you for this possibility. Thank you for your love and support and every sacrifice you made for me to be here. To my friends and family, I'm grateful you can celebrate this accomplishment with me, and I will always cherish the memories we've made during my college experience. To my fellow graduates, congrats on your success. Everything we experience here is just for ourselves, and no one can take that away from us. I hope your celebrations are filled with love and joy.
Congratulations to all the 2022 graduates. Against all odds, we did it. Juggling school, working full-time, and having a family and a personal life can be a lot. But through hard work, perseverance, and patience, we are capable of doing amazing things. Continue on the path of greatness. It's your time now. Make them see you.
I will remember the experiences I had at CSUSB for the rest of my life. Through the unwavering support and tutelage I received in the music department, I have developed the skills and confidence to be a musician in the professional world. The program has also provided me with unbelievable opportunities, such as performing locally with the San Bernardino Symphony Orchestra and internationally in South Korea. Thank you to my friends for always being there for me and for all the memories we've made. Muchísimas gracias a mi familia por todo el amor y apoyo que me han dado. No estuviera aquí sin ustedes. Congrats to the class of 2022. We did it!
Today, my 10-year journey comes to an end. I have struggled with crippling anxiety and depression, but through philosophy, I have learned that our minds are powerful. On my cap, I have written, Cogito ergo sum. I think, therefore I am. And you are too. Thank you to the philosophy department for this honorable recognition, with a special thank you to Professor Davidson and my counselor, Alyssa. Y a mi familia, gracias por creer en mí. Échale ganas si se puede.
Storytelling is one of the most powerful tools a human can possess. We as artists have the opportunity to impact lives through performance. My 4 years in the theater department have taught me to speak my truth, take risks, and to find rather than invent. I would like to thank the faculty and staff for their guidance in allowing me to grow and discover as a performer, my friends for being by my side every step of the way, and my family for being my biggest cheerleaders in this journey. Here's to the end of Act One. I can't wait to see what we accomplish in Act Two.
Six years ago, I immigrated from Mexico to pursue a brighter future. As a third-generation student, I am grateful for the opportunities I have received through my educational journey. Thank you to the World Languages Department, my professors, friends, and my family for always believing in my potential. Without your continued support, I wouldn't be standing here today. Class of 2022, keep believing in your dreams. Anything in this life is possible. Gracias a mi madre, que siempre me ha apoyado, y a mis seres queridos que tanto me quieren. Este logro es nuestro.
Now it gives me great pleasure to introduce the Dean of the James R. Watson and Judy Rodriguez Watson College of Education, Dr. Chinaka Dongwanchigu.
Hello, my name is Chinaka Dongwanchigu, and I have the honor of being the Dean of the James R. Watson and Judy Rodriguez Watson College of Education. Welcome to the Spring 2022 Commencement. The College of Education at CSUSB can actually claim to be the oldest college on campus, because when this institution was started in 1965, it was with the goal of training teachers. And since that time till now, this campus has produced at least 10,000 teachers, counselors, school site administrators, school psychologists, who are working and have worked in various parts of the Inland Empire. This academic year alone, we have the privilege of graduating at least 540 teachers, counselors, and school psychologists despite the pandemic. Our college has a vision that says we want to be the premier provider of teachers, counselors, and educational leaders in this region. So today we gather to commission yet another set of graduates, men and women that are adequately prepared to go out and make a difference in the world. Some of these graduates started their programs during the pandemic. They stayed the course. Through pure grit and tenacity, they were not deterred. Somebody talked about students who go to school and have family and have a full-time job. That is the College of Education students. Let's give them a round of applause. So let me say a few words to you, class of 2022. You're coming into a profession that is challenged today. You are entering the educational field at a time when the politicians are setting up hotlines for parents to complain about their teachers, when there is censor on what you can teach as a classroom teacher. But I want you to also know that you're entering this profession at the right time in the history of this nation. Because you are probably the last stop for American democracy. We hope that you as educators will serve your students with optimism, believing that you can help them and work with them to build a better future, not just for themselves, but for the nation. We hope you will embrace your calling as educators and make a commitment to make a difference through your practice. And so, I want to charge you to look forward with optimism and make a difference in the world. Before I conclude my speech, I would like to give a special recognition to students who have stood out among our student population. We have the honor of having the only doctoral program on campus. And I would like to recognize our outstanding doctoral student. When I call your name, please stand up and come out here. Teresa Gonzalez. Oscar Ruiz. Teresa is the outstanding doctoral student for the year 2022. Oscar is the outstanding graduate student for 2022. And finally, it gives me the honor to introduce the fourth president of Cal State San Bernardino, Dr. Thomas Morales.
Good evening. On behalf of California State University San Bernardino, I welcome you to this in-person commencement ceremony featuring graduates from the College of Arts and Letters and the James R. Watson and Judy Rodriguez Watson College of Education. Congratulations to the class of 2022. All here join you in celebrating this landmark achievement. This is your moment. Graduates, you have every right to be proud of your accomplishments. You achieved the goal of earning your degree under some of the most difficult circumstances ever faced by a college class. The global pandemic has affected all of us and changed the way we live our lives. The transition from in-person instruction to virtual learning did more than just alter the daily routine. It took everyone out of the familiar and forced a drastic adjustment of how we do nearly everything. As you commemorate this meaningful accomplishment, take time to remember what it took to realize it. This achievement should encourage and empower you. The majority of challenges we face in our lives are typically unforeseen and untimely. You have done far more than display the ability to face the unexpected. You have proven you can adapt, overcome, and succeed. Your success was made possible by the support of those closest to you, many who are here in the audience, as well as others unable to attend. Would all the parents, family members, relatives, spouses, and friends of our graduates, please stand. Graduates, please recognize these significant people who have given you their encouragement, their understanding, and their love. I now ask all our incredible CSUSB faculty members to please stand. Our faculty are among the best educators and researchers in the country. This ceremony is their celebration as well. Your professors care deeply about your success, and today they share in your joy. Graduates, please recognize the faculty who have given you the benefit of their knowledge, their experience, and their selfless attention. Thank you, faculty. The staff at CSUSB are at the heart of nearly every aspect of this institution. These talented and dedicated individuals provide critical services, essential maintenance, and vital support that enhance our learning environment. Graduates, please recognize the staff who have supported you with their time and their compassion. I know many here are the first in their families to earn a college degree, breaking a barrier and setting themselves up as role models for for siblings, relatives, and future generations. Would all those graduates who are the first in their family to receive a four-year degree please stand and be recognized? Oh yeah, oh yeah, this is a party. We're celebrating. Some of you here today have overcome tremendous challenges to achieve this personal goal. By prevailing over these difficulties, you have exceeded your own expectations. Congratulations on a job well done. Graduates, I want to talk to you today about a word I think you hear frequently. Sustainability. When you hear it, the first thing you think of is addressing climate change or preparing for the new conditions we will have to grapple with as our world becomes hotter. Am I right? But let's dig a little deeper. Merriam-Webster tells us that sustainability is about using a resource so that the resource is not depleted or permanently damaged. So sustainability is not about preserving or freezing things as they are. No, it is about how we use those resources responsibly and thoughtfully so that they continue to sustain our world into the future. Sustainability is about action. We hear about environmental changes a lot. In fact, you are part of a generation which has grown up keenly aware of the impact that a swiftly changing climate will have on your future. You watch the mega fires, the floods, and the droughts happening around the world and here in California, our home. National Public Radio reported in April that nearly all of Californians and much of the United States West is in severe to extreme drought. The reporting added that we can see stricter rules on water use and another devastating wildfire season. And we are still grappling with the ongoing pandemic COVID-19, which has disrupted all of our lives and the way in which you have pursued your degree here at CSUSB. Sustainability means that we need to be prepared for the pandemic that comes after COVID. That requires using what we have learned, that is the resources we have gained through sometimes painful experience, so that we are able to grapple with tomorrow's challenges. We have been talking sustainability or taking sustainability steps at CSUSB to address climate change on both our San Bernardino and Palm Desert campuses. These include creating an Office of Sustainability in 2017 to oversee our efforts, establishing a net zero energy goal, which means transitioning to sustainable energy sources, addressing our water use. We have an advantage here because CSUSB is home to the Water Resource Institute, a leading storehouse of water policy, science, and history. Partnering with Trees Campus USA, because trees deflect the radiation from the sun, releasing more moisture into the air to make it cooler. Offering sustainable foods on campus, coming to a goal of zero waste, constructing buildings which are certified as sustainable by LEED, the most widely used green building rating system in the world, ensuring that our $62 million endowment is invested in sustainable companies and organizations. That is literally putting our money where our mouth is. And finally, Provost Sherry McMahon has led a campus-wide committee with targeting subcommittees, which has spent the last 12 months envisioning how we need to act here at CSUSB to ensure our university's sustainability into the far future. So when we talk about sustainability, yes, we are referring to those things I just mentioned. But when we look at the question, how do we build a future that is healthy and positive, that allows our communities to thrive, we need to answer by widening our perspective even further. Because you will be part of building those communities of the future. You are part of that sustainability that we all need. It starts with the type of education that we strive to provide you with at CSUSB. This includes the robust educational pathways that you followed as you have pursued your degree. We are dedicated to ensuring that those pathways continue to adapt and still and shift along with real-world conditions. This includes sharing with you not only academic knowledge itself, but also providing the training and how to analyze, utilize, and build on it as you continue on a path of lifelong learning. It includes you being part of a learning community which strives to practice the values of diversity, equity, and inclusion each and every day. As you have grown your knowledge of DEI and how it can be practiced, you will take that knowledge and those skills with you into the way you live your life post-graduation. Communities which recognize the worth in every individual, respecting and celebrating the differences in culture, language, gender, religion, lifestyle, those are the communities where people can feel safe to thrive and find happiness and fulfillment. It means realizing that growing a career will also involve building on past experiences and adjusting to even anticipating an ever-changing working world landscape. That is what a sustainable career pathway means. None of this is easy, particularly in the last couple of years. We have each of us struggled with the very human response to all of the changes we have had to face. I can't do this. It's too hard. I know because I used those same words years ago when I was considering college and facing the challenge that was all around me back then. Nevertheless, I've had a long and satisfying career in higher education, built on not only using available resources, but also striving to use them thoughtfully and responsibly so that I can grow them and pass them along. The truth of sustainability is not just about our own lives, but about how we can positively impact the lives of others and the world around us. That boast in your sustainability has not only come from your own efforts, but also from the hands that have reached out to you. They may have been family members, friends, professors, or a member of the university staff who gave you an assist. Because sustainability does not happen in isolation. It can only happen in community. So today, celebrate what you have achieved and face your future with the clear-eyed knowledge that practicing sustainability will allow you to meet and exceed the challenge that life will present to you. Sustainability is about taking ownership of your own life. That doesn't mean exercising some type of perfect control. Instead, it means thoughtfully using the resources that life gives you to build your tomorrow. Those resources are knowledge, experience, success, failure, happiness, and even loss. Don't be afraid to be afraid. I'll put it another way. Don't let the fears of what many come stop you from moving forward, because you have your degree now, earned during a global pandemic, and the knowledge and tools to build a sustainable tomorrow. You have this now. Go out and pursue sustainability in all that you do. I believe in you, graduates. Your future is bright. We now begin with our honorary degree presentation. At this time, I invite Dr. Paulette Brown Hines to join me here at the podium. Paulette, Sherry. This is a momentous occasion for CSUSB. We have the privilege to bestow our highest honor on someone who has had a profound impact on the students and faculty of our university, as well as throughout our state and nationally. Dr. Paulette D. Brown is a well-known and widely respected philanthropist, business, and community leader who has made significant contributions to different communities throughout the state. She is the founder of Voice Media Ventures and a second-generation publisher of the Black Voice News, the first Black American online news publication on the West Coast. Under her leadership as the publisher, the Black Voice News has chronicled some of the most important stories impacting the lives of Black Californians throughout, giving a voice to the community while expanding its scope of civic involvement and addressing issues from disparities in health, education, and wealth to police violence, social justice, and civil rights battles. An award-winning columnist and Knight Digital Media Fellow, she has nearly 30 years' experience in media communications and community engagement. Her service on multiple influential boards has led to her becoming the first African American elected to lead the California News Publishers Association, the largest and oldest trade association for the news publishing industry in the state. She is also the first African American to chair the Inland Empire Community Foundation Board. As a lifelong student of African American literature, which was cultivated right here at Cal State San Bernardino, she leads Underground Railroad study tours for the Black Voice Foundation, stewards a collection of rare antebellum slavery artifacts, and is the founder of Mapping Black California, a community mapping and STEAM initiative. She has published various scholarly articles on 20th century Black women writers and has taught both here at CSUSB and at the University of California, Riverside. The university and the CSU are grateful to be able to recognize this outstanding California leader who is dedicated to making a difference and whose life, and whose life has an ongoing impact on our campus, the state, and our nation. I would now like to read from the citation that accompanies the degree who we are about to confer. In recognition of her many accomplishments and extensive contributions to the university and the community, the Board of Trustees of the California State University and California State University San Bernardino are proud to confer Dr. Paulette D. Brown Hines the honorary degree, Doctor of Humane Letters. Congratulations, Paulette.
So good to see all of you. Thank you, Provost McMahon, and thank you, Dr. Morales. And today's graduates, I join your friends and family and the faculty and staff in celebrating your tremendous achievement tonight. 8 years ago, I stood on the Cal State San Bernardino commencement stage in Casulas Arena as my father's guest and his voice. He was also the recipient of the honorary doctorate. And because he has a neuromuscular condition and it has impacted his speech, he asked me to deliver the remarks he composed. I shared a little about his life growing up in a family of sharecroppers from North Carolina and how he and my mother never forgot their humble roots once they started their own family and settled in San Bernardino. Nor did they forget their parents' teachings on the importance of serving the community, being an advocate for those who can't advocate for themselves, and always, always fighting for justice and just causes. My father's home today and he couldn't be here. I hope my mother is here, but I do wanna recognize Hardy and Cheryl Brown for all that they've done, not just for our family, but for this community. I proudly stand here today, honored to receive the same special recognition that my father received, and reflect on how much those same teachings of my parents and grandparents gave me and my siblings a sense of purpose that we carry with us in our professional and personal lives. I see it in my sister Lynn and her commitment to ending food insecurity in her community. My brother Hardy, who is inspiring others through his work and historical empathy. And my sister Regina, in her commitment to supporting those of us entrusted with the responsibility of telling our community's stories. And I see it in the homes that we've made for ourselves, my husband Rick Kirby, who's a professor at UC Riverside, and then our son Alexander, whose compassion for the plight of others is global in scope. And in the sense of purpose expressed in the next generation in our family, like my niece Kennedy, whose volunteerism and commitment to making the world around her a better place to live. I like to believe that this sense of purpose is because of our sharecropping roots, not in spite of them. So 32 years ago, I sat wearing a cap and gown at my own commencement ceremony at Cal State San Bernardino. I had no idea what the next three decades would hold, but I was full of anticipation, enthusiasm, and a sense of purpose that was nurtured at home, but truly discovered during my time on campus. And probably, like many of you graduates, I also felt a little fear. I had just mastered the college thing and had become really great at being a student, like really great at it. And I wasn't so sure what life would be like after that, which is probably why I went to graduate school and remained a student for another 6 years. We saw today, so many of you are first in your families to attend college, which is amazing. And we heard in those testimonials, and I know so many of you have stories, where the road to this graduation has not been an easy one. And you may be sitting there a little fearful too. But trust me, you got this. Cal State has prepared you well. As you continue your journey in life, remember that it's not just that you look to find purpose in work. I hope, like me, you stay focused on your greater purpose in life, whatever that is. Again, congratulations, class of 2022, and thank you for allowing me to share this special day with you.
So please, we're ready now to rumble here. We're ready to have this party. Thank you, Dr. Paulette Brown-Hines. Thank you. But before we get started, I want to recognize, I want to acknowledge something with you, share something with you. Today is the last commencement that our beloved provost will preside over, the last College of Arts and Letters and College of Education commencement. We've been very fortunate at Cal State San Bernardino to have an incredible leader, incredible chief academic officer, so dedicated to student success, faculty, and staff success. Please join me in wishing her our very best wishes as she assumes the presidency at Eastern Washington University.
Now it's really time to rumble. Congratulations, Dr. Brown-Hines. We are now ready for the conferral of our doctoral degrees. Will the candidates for the doctoral and educational leadership please rise? President Morales, as provost of the university and upon the recommendation of the faculty, I have the honor to present these candidates who are deemed worthy of this distinction for the awarding of the doctorate.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the trustees of the California State University, I confer upon those of you who have met the requirements, the doctoral degree. Congratulations.
Let us begin.
Teresa Gonzalez, their dissertation, under the guidance of their chair, Dr. Sharon Brown-Welty, is titled, Does the Use of Digital Storytelling Affect the Self-Efficacy and Writing Ability of Long-Term English Learners?
Aurora Vilches, their dissertation, under the guidance of their chair, Dr. Enrique Morillo, is titled, Experiences of Latina Student Mothers in the Transfer Pipeline, an Interpretive Phenomenological Analysis. Susie Abdel Sharweed, their dissertation under the guidance of their chair, Dr. Enrique Murillo, is titled, Beyond the Hijab. Lived Experiences of Female Hijabi Muslim International Students at a Southern California University.
Danny Babin, their dissertation, under the guidance of their chair, Dr. Andrew Hughes, is titled Examination of Experiential Phenomena Influencing Culinary Educators' Pedagogical Content Knowledge.
We are now ready for the conferral of the master's degree. Will the candidates for the master's degree please rise? President Morales, as Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, and upon the recommendation of the faculty, I have the honor to present these candidates who are deemed worthy of this distinction for the award of the master's degree.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the trustees of the California State University, I confer upon those of you who have completed the requirements, the master's degree. Congratulations.
Will the candidates for the master's degree please be seated until directed to come forward by the marshals? Let's begin, marshals.
Thank you.
Destiny McNeely.
Juliana Hasroon. Deborah DaCosta. Samantha Gomez.
Katia Ramirez.
Naeem Aburadi. Mary Rose Camarillo.
Jose Perez.
Ja Wei Hu.
Howard Wagner. Miranda Simpson. Rebecca McKinney. Diana Martin Venero.
Yesenia Grajeda Campos.
Valeria Petch.
Amanda Carrillo. Daniel Lay.
Michael Perez.
Jessica Anna. Antoine Fonseca. Angela Barrow. Ashley Gonzalez. Laura Dover.
Liliana Davalos.
Matthew Lackey.
Melina Romo Loera. Michelle Schneider. Jessica O'Handley. Michelle Story. Brittany Peacock.
June Lomax.
Jana Rayton. Brenda Velasco. Corrine Sussman.
Alexandra Hernandez.
A.G. Warren.
Ricardo Hernandez.
Stephanie Rascon.
Sierra Castillo.
Carla Elizabeth Vasquez.
Rosemary Agras.
Jasmine Medina.
Joanna Hargis. Nicole De La Cruz. Sophia Lemus.
Diana Rodriguez. Bianca Perez. Jacqueline Rochin Angulo. Josh Peraza.
Melissa Cardenas. Chelsea Bruning. Silveria Sedano. Julie Colindovich.
Allison Skokos.
Loretta Flores.
Sophia Martinez.
Michelle DeMar.
Carla Guin.
Brooke Schapter.
Travis Goddard.
Miranda Ward.
Ruben Arietta. Angela Diaz. Kathleen Garcia. Kaylee Chavez. Lupe Gomez. Kayla Cherry. Erica Florido. Lauren Fernandez. Tanya Esquivel.
Belisi Salguero. Oscar Ruiz.
Robin Hinchliffe.
Isabel Millward Pena.
Olivia Duran.
Sandra Otero. Madeline Simmons. Elizabeth Soto.
Verd Lee Johnson. Francisco Baeza.
Brenda Nievas.
Dulce Gonzalez. Stephanie Cubillo. Courtney Bradshaw. Joanna Leal Sanchez.
Elaine Rodriguez.
Kimberly Bolaños Alcocer.
Fungwin Nguyen. Amanda Rose De Lara. Jessica Saunder. Lorena Saruf. Kendall Ramos. Nicole Smith. Anayeli Mendez Sanchez. Marisol Montano.
Luis Espitia. Nancy Cuautle. Miranda Bravo Alcadumi. Blanca Juarez.
Maria Ramos. Jeanette Magallon. Leslie Salgado. Patricia Velasco Reyes.
Jorge Cervantes Lopez. Romico Kellenberger.
Mariah Moomin. Marcos Villegas.
Sabrina Garcia. Brett Garcia. Melissa Levy.
Emma Rumpf Snavely. Ermelinda Ortiz. Jennifer Neri. Wendy Toledano. Wendy Solis.
Ariel Cheatwood.
Carrie Mendez.
Xavier Aguayo.
Lorenzo Pena. Kimberly Romero Vargas. Salvador Perez. Elizabeth Pritchard.
Delfina Lustano. Nicholas Briseño.
Yahaira Oseguera Rocha.
Angelica Juarez.
Rachel Richardson. Carmen Sanchez. Ana Resendez. Ariel Newell.
Beatrice Bayona Mendia.
Nisa Munoz.
Ameyali Baena Nieto.
Zina Masali. Joan Moi. Evelyn Ulloa. Casey Royster. Karen Ramirez. Nancy Mora.
Maribel Lopez.
Ifalma Ofora.
Marlene Cervantes.
Kareli Rivas. Margaret Repko. Daisy Velasco.
Joseph Cassidy.
Gina Mairena. Mariel Tabino. Alexia Martinez.
Sarah Lebovitz. Ola Bore Lawal.
Alicia Zuniga. Dishina Nathakumar.
Joanna Clevenger.
Adriana Vega.
Diana Hernandez Aguilar. Joseph Honnell.
Gloria Marón. Lisette Rumbo. Sochil Trujillo Flores. Evelyn Magana. Alexis Rodriguez. Fabian Torres.
Destiny Espinoza. Marilena Garcia. Eleanor May Guanzen. Ruby Becerril Gonzalez.
Laura Ortega. Andrea Pulido.
Melanie Asalde Smith. Gabrielle Ariano.
Nicole Moyer. Melissa Medina.
I would now like to recognize three groups of graduates who have maintained a record of academic excellence. The first group includes those students who have achieved a cumulative grade point average of 3.5 to 3.74, and they are wearing maroon cords. Will the students graduating cum laude please stand and be recognized? Thank you. The second group includes those students who have achieved a cumulative grade point average of 3.75 to 3.89, and they are wearing gold cords. Will the students graduating magna cum laude please stand and be recognized? Thank you. The final group includes those students who have achieved a cumulative grade point average of 3.9 to 4.0, and they are wearing maroon and gold cords. Will the students graduating summa cum laude please stand and be recognized? Congratulations. And finally, I would like to acknowledge those who are wearing the spirit cords. These individuals have shown their Coyote pride by supporting scholarships for current students and future alumni. If you're wearing the spirit cords, please stand and we will recognize you. Thank you. You may be seated. The bachelor's degree will now be awarded. Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree please rise? President Morales, upon the recommendation of the faculty, I have the honor to present these candidates who are deemed worthy of the distinction for the award of the bachelor's degree.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the trustees of the California State University, I confer upon those of you who have met the requirements, the bachelor's degree. Please change your tassel from right to left. Congratulations.
Will the candidates please be seated until directed to come forward by the marshals? We respectfully request that parents, friends, and students remain in their seats until the end of the ceremony as a courtesy to the graduates who have not yet received their diplomas. We begin today's bachelor's degree with Francisco Avila. Francisco Avila is being awarded a posthumous Bachelor of Arts degree in English with a creative writing concentration. Francisco's mother, Domitila Avila, will be accepting his degree. Francisco Avila. Marshals, let's begin.
Vanessa Gaspar, Francisco Avila, Tiffany Doe, Trisha Gensel,
Martin Romero,
Christine Dill, Azucena Aguirre Reyes,
Jessica Mondragon,
Gregory Krause,
Ayinde Mitchell, Ricardo Moctezuma, Perla Maldonado,
Jordan Castellanos,
Ferris Strawn,
Geneva Lexine Cabanada, Michael Garut,
Melanie Martinez,
Christian Andrews, Saya Cabrera Gonzalez,
Myung-un Son,
Ivan Jose Hernandez, Julia Carrillo, Brittany Borrego,
Caitlin Patton,
Elizabeth Franco, John Hunter, Angelo Escobar, Delaney Gordon, Francis Brazo, Andrea Gutierrez, Vanessa Barrios, Emily Lyons,
Dahlia Marin, Jeffrey Villanueva,
Tanya Fisher,
Eduardo Mejia Lopez, Martin Munoz,
Lexis Garcia,
Anthony Hernandez,
Sandra Ramirez, Sophia Sáenz, Clarissa Sanchez, Alex Santana, Fong Vu, Maria Rios Felix, Kelly McMullen, Marlene Ruesca Robles, Hannah Shen,
Bianca Delgadillo, John Harford, Marissa Garcia, Cody Clements, Nicholas Godlewski, Alyssa Lopez,
Kelly Provines,
Gualtemo Alvarado, Patrick Klein,
Ayana Soto, Evelyn Salgado, Jose Suosnabar, Kristen Rainey, Jessica McCartney, Amor Martinez. Brianna Vara. Amy Reyes. Valerie Villanueva Beltran.
Catherine Hillier.
Misael Perez. Tiffany Sosa. Valerie Navarrete.
Donna Briggs. Mariah Armstrong. Felix Waman. Kareem Abdullah.
Stephanie Miller. Marisol Perez.
Arien Gonzalez.
Hefte Montez.
Lana Clay. Edwin Alvarez Loza. Mary Chester. Ileana Alvarenga.
Cherie Talbot. Madison Taylor. Eileen Ramos.
Angelica Coriel. Stephen Israel. Marissa Aguirre.
James Stanfield.
Kelsey Landa Uribe.
Angela Sanabria.
Marley Gonzalez.
Kristen Thomas Medina. Sarah Waggle.
Cynthia Arnstead. Christine Anderson. Nylea Barreto. Madison Duarte.
Lila Meza. Marley Parrott. Melissa Zacharias.
Susanna Gonzalez Razo. Benjamin Guerra.
Francesca Ramos.
Vanessa Diaz. Olivia DeVillas. Kelly Casey. Ben Garcia. Jessica Hara.
Paula Romero. Francesca Maxine Vista.
Sarah Kelly. Alicia Clark. Dulce Arvalo Nicolas. Anthony Jones. Winter Jackson. Jennifer Lopez. Bianca Barragan. Holly Beltran. Opal Belial. Noemi Ibarra.
Jacqueline Reyes. Christina Munoz Orozco.
Phoebe Crawford. Alex Garcia Cardenas.
Heather Moran.
Alondra Herrera. Daisy Lopez.
Estela Ramirez. Alexa Marin. Christopher Macias.
Reina Esparza.
Alexis Zolko. Alondra Mendez Acosta. Brian Martinez.
Alyssa Knapp. Morena Arroz. Brittany Bevins. Danielle Barrios.
Brianna Orellana.
Tiffany Bowles. Tina DeVella. Marissa Diaz. Denise Gonzalez.
Stephanie Uribe. Rebecca Rios. Elena Saprinetti. Denise Magana.
Ileana Hernandez. Stephanie Carrillo. Evelyn Lopez Seja.
Solomon Munger.
Katarina Escoto. Haley Anderson. Travis Love.
Leslie Sanchez. Maria Elena Sutton. Serena Young. Leslie Villa.
Leilani Kamai.
Monica Rodas. Wendy Velazquez Aldama. Jose Perez. Christian McCowan. Megan Wheeler. Watana Suos. Alexa Solario. Aurora Morales.
Jackie Altamirano Martinez.
Paulina Mendoza. Evelyn Maleno.
Kelly Eller.
Bridget Wilhide.
Gabriela Gonzalez Perez.
Samantha Turner. Diana Perez.
Edgar Carranza.
Christina Shook. Saul Sanchez. Veronica Morales.
Noemi Lomeli.
Hannah Salcedo. Vanessa Marquez.
Lance Higgins.
Justin Nocon. Adamaris Maldonado.
Annette Estrada.
Jewel Quemada.
Julissa Barragan.
David Ramos.
Ariana Garcia.
Anjali Prasad.
Gabriella Ledesma. Charlotte Corliss. Kiara LaFontaine.
Travel Washington.
Daphne Fuentes.
Gabriela Padilla.
Francisco Xavier Lopez.
Samantha Rosas. Alice Montano.
Caitlin Barrios.
Cynthia Perez.
Esmeralda Luna.
Nissa Villarreal.
Robin Hayes.
Prisma Magdaleno. Andrea Zamaripa.
Maria Corona.
LaDeja Wright.
Veronica Guerrero. Erica Burns. Isabella Lanis. Christian Celeste.
Donna Panagiotopoulos. Jeremy Vigil.
Marlene Camberos.
Monica Serrato.
Alondra Baruman. Michael Seha. Shelby Clark. Gemma Diaz Garcia.
Ernestina Soto. Dominique Zometa. Myra Silva.
Matthew Glover.
Andrea Martinez.
Juliana Garate Galindo. McKenna Fournier.
Valeria Morales.
Leilani Ramirez.
Leah Gallegos. Isabel Figueroa Parra.
David Perez Luis. Maria Moreno. Mackenzie Price. Juan Rosas.
Naomi Buffa. Edgar Lopez Anguiano. Giselle Lopez. Samantha Flores. Margaret Allenbaugh.
Paulina Morales Garcia.
Sarah Bridgewater. Gabriela Cruz.
Natalie Razon.
Clarissa Corrett. Melissa Casas.
Anelcy Pimentel Meza.
Jonathan Arvizu. Alexia Lizarraga Ichavez. Cassandra Jimenez. Sophia Lopez. Jessica Franco. Elizabeth Barron Torres. Alejandro Galindo.
John Malapitan. Alexandra Marquez.
Aparajita Barua. Tasia Espino Ramirez.
Kiara Oregon.
Daniel Alaniz. Luis Escobar Gutierrez. Daniel Alas.
Andres Mendoza. Claire Shoemate.
Jose Guerrero Duarte.
John Perez. Paula Monaco.
Brent Jake Seralde.
Elizabeth Suarez. Robert Wirtz. Isabel Malero.
Nicholas Diaz. Annalisa Getz. Bianca Guerrero. Oluwatoyosi Akinremi. Cassidy Jessup.
Dalton Rush.
Joshua Fear. Isabel Lopez. David Garcia Tlahuel.
Nikki Nagila.
Manuel Inzunza.
Mary Ann Real. Angelica Ruiz.
David Babao.
Tanya Esmeraldo Vasquez. Latrice Maness.
Jason Lucero. Jennifer Arana. Joshua Albon. Jonathan Bingham. Stephanie Gonzalez.
Susanna Munoz. Genesis Obispo.
Joshua Browner.
Taylor Sally. Joshua Reisinger.
Alyssa Beck. Jennifer Brown.
Erica Quiroz. Maria Urbina Valiosera.
Christian Gutierrez.
Reyes Ortega Gonzalez.
Pedro Gomez.
Sierra Perez.
Brianna Alvarez. Susan Felix. Emily Leva. Giovanni Aguilar.
Mayabel Ruiz.
Jacob Patrick Leon.
Milena Bray. Nathaniel Abadilla.
Alexis Ramos. Nicholas Torres. Claudia Ordaz Navarro. William Parada. Ulysses Mora Rodriguez.
Warren Gutierrez Diaz. Samantha Baker.
Saul Romero. Marcos Wedeking.
Ivan Lee Abreu. Gloria Diaz. Victoria Flores Suarez. Nicole Franco. Stephanie Alfonso. Astrid Cortez. Maura Cruz Castrillo. Astrid Cortez.
Marie Ortiz.
Hillary Bustamante. Roryana Bowman. Francini Gonzalez. Romeo Lorenzo Apollo.
Selena Roldan.
Kenya Johnson.
Brianna Owens. Amani Murioki. David Martinez.
Eloy Garcia.
Clarissa Vizcara. Andrea Smith.
Yusuf M. Kanbar.
Jordan Thomas. David Maris.
Leandrew Knight.
Diego Womack.
Jonathan E. Ciordia.
Yamilet Sanchez.
Nancy Icepuro. Bobby Fiorini. Brianna Aguilar. Hope Esperanza.
Natalie Martinez.
Eric Carlisle. Vasti Fontes. Sarah Lloyd. Karen Barrera.
Valerie Perez Tarango.
Stephanie Estrada. Atsiri Garcia.
Ricardo Martinez.
Francisco Barba. Eric King.
Aisha Nance.
Afra Kamal.
Christopher Turner. Zareen Rahim. Anthony Tighe.
Cesar Echevarria.
Kathy No.
Ashley Flores. Anna Maria Aparicio. Kristen Gonzalez. Andrea Betancourt. Daisy Gonzalez.
Fernando Martinez.
Brenda Gomez.
Myra Mendoza. Sergio Vargas.
Julia Estrada.
Amanda Mastrangelo. Emily Manila.
Anna Gonzalez Munoz.
Congratulations, graduates! You are awesome! I love you! You now join the ranks of this country's best and brightest. Oh, yeah. For the next phase of your lives, I urge you to draw on the tools of sustainability you have learned along with your academics and use them for the betterment of everyone. Show concern, appreciation, respect, and empathy, and a single word, care. Care about yourself, care about others, especially the less fortunate. Care about your community. Care about values and doing what's right. Care about the work you do. Care about learning. Care about the future. And most importantly, care about making this world better. You can do it. If you have the courage to do, to lead, and to change, trust me, you will make a difference and enjoy a successful and fulfilling life. CSUSB graduates, know that this university, your alma mater, will always be here for you. I encourage you to stay connected through our Alumni Association. You are entering a lifelong relationship and one that doesn't have to end with today's ceremony. One of the keys to building your life is to network. Network. And yes, network. CSUSB alumni can be a wonderful resource. You will find your fellow Coyotes all over the globe, wherever your career and life paths will take you. For those of you who return in the IE, or who remain in the IE, or come home to visit, 75% of our alumni live in Riverside and San Bernardino counties. You will find school teachers, social workers, healthcare providers, and school administrators among your fellow alumni. Go out and connect with them. A day does not go by that I do not connect with fellow Coyotes who are building and rebuilding the IE. Congratulations to Cal State San Bernardino class of 2021. I wish each and every one of you satisfaction, self-fulfillment, and success in all your future endeavors.
Now that you are officially alumni, I invite you to join us in singing the alma mater, the text of which is found in your program. So please stand for our alma mater, performed by Ariana Ruiz.
Thank you.
I also would like to extend my sincere congratulations to our new graduates. I ask that the audience please remain in their seats until the graduates have recessed. Family and friends may join the graduates for photographs on the south side of the building in parking lot D. Graduates, please remain in your rows until the marshals direct you to recess. And now, I'd like you to end this ceremony with a big howl. Yeah? On the count of three, let's see it. One, two, three. Ow.